Still cooling at what's left of a 120-year-old church.
Early this morning, fire destroyed the Sharon Chapel Church, located just southeast of Centerville. KCCI's Noelle Smith shows us why officials say it probably was not an accident.
Just before 6 Sunday morning, it was a deer hunter driving by to set up a tree stand that called it in.
It was an iconic church for the area. You go to anybody in Appanoose County and you talk about Sharon Chapel Church, they know exactly where they're talking.
The Sharon Chapel Church in Appanoose County sat atop a ridge at the intersection of two gravel roads. Between that hilltop view that helped make it so iconic and its wooden structure, it didn't stand much of a chance.
And obviously with the wind and the breeze, and you can see that it sits on top of a hill with a beautiful view overlooking a draw in a valley, so that the wind helped fuel the fire.
Once a white church with stained glass windows, it's now just a pile of ashes. Although it's been unused for some 10 years, the fire still surprised neighbors. Morning and afternoon, cars rolled slowly on by, its drivers gawking at the rubble. And for those with a personal connection to the church,
my great-grandmother, Catherine Eddy, donated all the lumber to build this church.
It's saddening.
My great-great grandparents McCoy donated the land at the same time to go with the church, so it's kind of a double whammy for me.
Built in 1890, this church had no gas or electricity, and there was no storm or lightning last night, leading the sheriff to treat it as a criminal investigation.
Where you have deputies that are actually interviewing people right now.
Part of the Sharon Chapel Cemetery Association, who owns and maintains the land, Cassidy says the building wasn't insured, making rebuilding an unlikely option.
We'll move on from this. We'll take care of our dead ones out there in the cemetery. We'll be all right. We'll survive. We always have.
Noelle Smith, KCCI News Channel 8, Iowa's News Leader.
If you have any information about the fire, you are asked to call one of the two numbers on your screen, either the Appanoose County Sheriff's Office or Appanoose County Crime Stoppers.
And this is not the only suspicious fire Appanoose County investigators are looking into.